never tell
you. Yo, if you give me the chance,
now,
girl,
baby,
I'm going
to understand that I forgive you. But I ain't going to forget that you brought me
baby, 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 baby. But I have grown from a thug to a man. Build my castle with bricks and no longer with sand. Oh, girl.
And just before I run to the plug, baby, I might listen to your song.
Move before you walk out that door. They said two wrongs don't make it right.
Don't make it right.
So if I'm wrong, I ain't trying to fight.
I'm trying
to have some dinner with some candlelight.
Could have been anywhere in the world, but you're here with me. I appreciate that. But Shizzle, my nizzle, used to dribble down in VA. Was hurting them in a...
So don't forget you're on to FCFM. On to your 7:30 teacher boys. My name is Ramit, your duty continuity announcer this afternoon. So the time now is 2 o'clock. Our next program is CRS 125. So have a listening.
This is CRS 125, Introduction to the Theology of the Old Testament. It is a one-credit unit course. The topic of our discussion today is the major components of the Old Testament theology. We discussed in our last lesson about the nature of God. Like we tried to emphasize that time, God is not somebody we can touch physically. And so you might begin to think, how come that we study God's nature? God's nature can be determined through several ways. For example, we say God is a spirit. And how do you see him? Okay. You say God is holy. How do you see his holy acts being performed? We say God is omnipotent. God is omniscient and so on and so forth. But when we look at the aspect of goodness and all the areas of the compassionate God, we try to look at how he has been operating with his people. Now, we discover God's way of operating through the nation of Israel. Because God actually revealed himself to this group of people. And so, we have discovered that God is love. And he actually bestowed his love on the people. Okay? In several experiences that they had. As he chose Abraham, the covenant he made with them ran through. So God is God of love. Another one, God is righteous, as we discussed. Okay? God is a sympathetic person. God is everywhere. God is all-knowing. Okay? See, we see God doing things in relation with people. We also tried to look at the fact that the basic ideas about the theology of the EOT actually had to do with the fact that the Old Testament has many sections. Now, the fourth section, when we look at the EOT in totality, it has to do with how God started his work with man. We see in Genesis, and then how he chose somebody like Moses. So the first one, Pentateuch, the law. See, God started and he chose a group of people. Okay? So we see the Pentateuch there. That is the law. Then we see historical experiences of the Jewish people from Joshua. Again, it's another area that God decided to talk to his people in several ways. Okay? Now, when we look at the Proverbs or the scriptural writings like the Psalms, okay, we see how God also dealt with his people in several ways. I mean, he had to reason with people in several ways. We also discovered in the prophets, okay, how God also had to do a lot of things with them. Now, each of these sections had basic information that God had to do with them. So we look at all those areas in the last lesson briefly. And of course, again, we try to consider man's own role in his relationship with God. What was man's role in God's in relationship with God? Man had to obey. Man had to obey. If God could entrust into man and said, rule and dominate the world, man has to obey God. Okay, and that was why the issue of the covenant came in there. So man's obedience was needed in order to follow God as he was operating. This was some things we discussed in our last lesson. And I'm sure we can go on from there to the new one today. By the end of this lesson, students are expected to define Old Testament theology, identify the importance of Old Testament theology, and also discuss the major components of Old Testament theology. The Old Testament theology is a systematic study about the nature of God and his relationship with his people. In looking at the Old Testament theology, we would want to look at the following so that we can consider them under our main topic. We cannot actually discuss the major components of the Old Testament theology without trying to explain what that means or without looking at some basic ideas that are associated with the Old Testament as we have been discussing. Ideally, I want us to look at this issue of what Old Testament theology stands for. Actually, theology can be looked at in various perspectives. But for us, we want to look at this course, just the introduction. We're not doing theology proper, it's just the introduction. But then, we still have to consider what theology means in a very simple way. The Old Testament, you know, it's a collection of many books. Of course, we have about 39 books in the Old Testament. and it's meant for the individual to study each of these books, look at the contents, and try to fish out some points out of it. Each book is peculiar, very, very peculiar. When you look at the Pentateuch, the historical studies, the writings, or something like the Proverbs, both the major and the minor prophets, you discover that each of these books or each of the sections actually has its own peculiar message being passed across to the reader. But then I want to look at this from this perspective, that it is a way of God trying to explain himself to man. So simply put, what is theology? The study of it is concerned mainly with an organized way of studying God, an organized way of studying God and his relationship with people. An organized way of studying God and his relationship with people. We've not seen God, but we know that God exists. So when we see the activities of God in several areas, we have to study him carefully. We have to study him carefully. And we can know this when we read the Old Testament. So the Old Testament theology, among other things, will help us to study God carefully. In fact, from the beginning of Genesis, we see in the beginning, God created. You see the name God first. Who is this God? How is his nature? How can we understand God? Especially as it relates with human beings. This is very, very important. We believe sincerely that God exists. And how does he relate with people? Okay? So the OT theology will help us to study God and then to understand how God operates with people. Now, even though we cannot see him, but we know he exists and he does a lot of things. So it is our business to study this area so that we can get ourselves well acquainted with God. Now we see events of the Genesis. For example, we see Exodus. We see also the Leviticus. That's looking at the Pentateuch now. We see Numbers. We see Deuteronomy. And then when we come to Joshua, Judges, 1st, 2nd Samuel, we see how God works with people. We could see how he works with people. Okay? So a careful study will reveal more about God to us. Now, I also want us to look at another point, how significant this OT theology is to us. Now you discover that it's very, very significant in several areas. The Old Testament, when you look at it carefully, tells us about the nature of God. God is a holy God. God is holy. God is pure. God is miraculous. God is merciful. He revealed himself to people of old in several ways, through dreams, through angels, and so on and so forth. So this OT books are very, very important for us to look at. So, you see, God actually has done a lot for the Israelites. Now, the way he related with the Israelites can be discovered in various ways. So it's very, very significant for us because of the way he has done his work. It's also significant because the histories we have discovered with his dealings with the Israelites, when we go through the history, all the various experiences they have with God, will also serve as a lesson to us so that we can be able to see how God worked with these people. Remember, he chose a generation of God from Abraham. He identified Abraham and chose him and used him to reach other parts of the world. In fact, in chapter 12 of Genesis there, God called Abraham and said, please leave your people. I'm going to use you. I'll bless you. Those who bless you, I'll bless them. Those who curse you, I'll curse them. And through you, all nations of the world shall be blessed. Okay? So the OT theology is very, very important in this area of looking at the experiences of the Israelites with God. And we're emphasizing Abraham now as their father. See? So the histories are very important. When we look at the history of Abraham, you know, his son Isaac, Jacob, before they came to Egypt and so on and so forth. Okay? It's also significant because we can see that the whole Old Testament books, the various, you know, areas of or sections, like the Pentateuch, there's a message there. Look at the history, historical books from Joshua. See a lot of things there. Look at the poetic books, like Songs of Solomon, like the Proverbs, like Psalms and so on. Each one has a peculiar message. And even the prophets. So when we study them, they really give us a lot of inspiration about how God operates. You see, now we want to, thirdly, we want to look at the areas of concern, i.e., as it has to do with God's own way of dealing with people, looking at subjects like the covenant, election, okay, salvation, and the rest of them. These are major components of the Old Testament theology, which is our main topic we want to discuss now. Now, it's not possible for God to just come down, you see him physically now, but through the covenant relationship, we know him. And so in this OT theology, as we introduce it, some basic components which I've mentioned are the covenant, election, salvation, remnant, kingship, and of course, we study Messiah, the Messiah. Now, for example, through covenant, we see God establishing a covenant with Noah after the experience of the flood. Okay? And there we've seen that the rainbow was used as a sign that God wouldn't destroy the world with water again. Okay? So we see the covenants that God made, they are meant to cement the relationship between God and his people. Of course, God initiated these covenants. And the major thing we'll consider is that the covenants really help, okay, to make man to be committed to work for God. Okay? Now, we also see Abrahamic covenant. God made covenant with Abraham. He said, I'll be a God to you. You'll be my people. And we discover that, that covenant really ran through. In fact, we discover that it even up to today is a major covenant we look at. Now, the terms of covenants were there. God actually was doing his own, and of course, the people were doing theirs. Okay? The essence of this covenant, of course, is the realization of God's own program, i.e. giving salvation to man. When Christ appeared on earth, we have discovered God promised Abraham, through your lineage, somebody will come who will bless the whole world. And of course, we have discovered that when Christ came, he blessed the whole world. That is the sense of the relation of that covenant. Well, again, another area we'll consider to look at, another component is salvation. Salvation has to do with freedom. It has to do with liberation. On many occasions, the Israelites had problems, and we saw God saving them. One of the experiences which we can consider is the crossing of the Red Sea in Exodus. See how God delivered them. See how he liberated them from their enemies. And even before they crossed the Red Sea, see how they moved from Egypt. See? So the salvific act of God is one of the components of the Old Testament theology. In fact, through studying God's way of saving people, we know more about God. Like I told you about covenant. Through the covenant, we know more about God. We can study his nature through that. And now salvation. What of election? Election is God's own way of choosing people. God will choose and say, I have chosen you. In fact, he told the Israelites, I have chosen you. It's not because you are the best set of people on earth, but I have chosen you to use you to reach other parts of the world. Election has to do with God's own way of favoring individuals. It can be done as to an individual. It can be for a group of people. For example, God chose Moses, and he used him to reach others. Okay? God chose David. He used him to reach others. Sometimes, God can choose somebody temporarily and use him. We saw the story of Jephthah at that time. When we go to Judges, we see many stories about how God chose people in time. Deborah was there. He chose Deborah to use him. Okay? And many others that God used in the Old Testament. Of course, kings were chosen. Although some of them were not faithful. But when we look at the process of election, how they were anointed. Now, what we are saying is that it's an aspect of people relating to God through election. Okay? God elects an individual and he will use him. Another way is we see the idea of remnant. You see, when we talk of remnant in the Bible, well, it's a way of God trying to say, even if people have offended me, I will not destroy totally. So the idea of the remnant is to show God's love for people. That even if people have been destroyed for the sins they have committed, okay, by using one hand to push them away, he will use the second hand to draw them closer to him again. Of course, we discover that even when the Israelites went for this Babylonian captivity, the idea of the remnant there was that God used the remnant to do a lot of things, to carry out his assignments, which he has actually given to Israelites through the covenant. So remnant, through this idea of remnant, people could also know more about God. God does not destroy totally. Okay? We have seen God operating in this way. Also, through the election of kings, God actually revealed himself to people. So, a study of kingship would show us more about who God is. Okay? We have seen many kings in the Bible, in the Old Testament. Similarly, Messiah is a major theological point to be discussed in the OT. God has revealed himself through the coming of the Messiah. And of course, we have discovered this in the OT. Well, of course, well, the Messiah appeared in the NT, and we have seen this through the Lord Jesus Christ. Okay, so through all these major components, we know more about God God can be known through all these things I've listed. Let us try to go through our lessons again. I'm sure you can recall some of the things we have discussed. Let's try and recap. In fact, the interesting thing about this lesson today is that it has exposed us to some of the basic things we need to know about how God relates with his people. Now, we can define Old Testament theology simply as a systematic way or a scientific way, an organized way of studying God. God is an organized person. We have seen people in the Old Testament, even the entertainers, about this God, the experiences they've had with God. For example, you discover that in the Old Testament, when some of the people didn't understand it much, if God provided, they say God the provider. When God healed, they say God the healer. Can you see? That was the way they understood him. And then gradually, they have come to understand him to be God who is everything. And that's why the name Yahweh came up. Because that Yahweh covers several other names of God. Now, you discover that for individuals to do this, a lot of reflection was needed. Okay? So, God can be known. Yes, God can be known in several ways. The Jewish people were chosen, and God used them to reach other parts of the world. In fact, the pride of a typical Jewish man is that he has no God. He has no God, Yahweh, the only living God, the Almighty God, the only one God. And so we can know him, and this can be done through our careful study of the OT theology. Now, it's very, very significant for it because, you see, the various books of the OT, like I said before, various books, each of them has its own message, and the various groups, like I said, the Pentateuch, i.e. the law, has its own peculiar message. God performing miracles through his people. So that's very, very significant for us. And we see God operating. For example, let's look at the question of the Red Sea. See how God defended this group of people against their enemies. That is great. So these books contained in the Old Testament, which we study, are very, very relevant for us to see. And God, in his own way, told people a lot about his own nature through this. All of them are significant because they carried important messages that can help humanity. What of the law? Through the laws God gave, man knew how to direct himself here and there. Okay? Through Proverbs, we see wisdom. Through Psalms, we see how people knew God, okay, in thanksgiving and other things. And songs and so on and so forth. And one can be ministered to through songs. See individuals, kings that God used to reach people. OT theology. I also want to talk about this briefly again, about the major components, which of course we have said before. Now, for example, let's pick just one, and maybe we can add one if there's time. Salvation. Look at God created Adam. Adam fell. He fell. He disobeyed God. But God didn't leave man like that. He made another way again. Look at the time of Noah. He chose Noah. Look at the time of Abraham. He chose Abraham. And he used Abraham to do many things. God has eternal plan for man's salvation. Okay? And this salvation, apart from the eternal one, temporary one also was experienced through God helping them to win various wars. They were victorious over their enemies in several areas which we have discovered. Okay? So salvation was one of the components of the Old Testament theology. Okay? Look at the covenant. Look at the idea of remnant. Like Messiah was the anointed one that God has brought through the land of David, that God said was going to use even in the last age to stop the activities of Satan and reign on earth. Reign on earth. Okay? So God chose Messiah.